dedicated to my grandmother. I'll do that one. She used to make all kinds of soups and stuff. Alright. She did. She made like oxtail. Alright. Oxtail soup is good. You ever had that soup? Good as hell. Okay. Dedicated to my grandmother, right? She wanted to, you know, get to America, give a better life to her kids, grandkids, and all that. So she figured, in order to get into America, you gotta learn some English. So all Americans speak English. She's gonna need to learn some English without an accent so she can blend in. So in order for her to learn this unaccented English, she moved from Panama to Jamaica. Because she figured Jamaican English has no accent, and that would let her blend in. It probably made sense at the time, I don't know. But here's the poem, and it's dedicated to her. Rolling ocean crashed between her toes, sand built the coastline she tightroped yesterday to her back. Facing tomorrow with the Panamanian sun set in the most black of her mouth, full of clumsy English, rickety on her Spanish tongue, shuffling Caribbean accent marks inconspicuously and full masquerade, my grandmother was a dream catcher. Hopscotching countries, jumping identity double dutch, watching greener shades of brown grass darken every time she landed behind a language barrier. She clutched yesterday's tongue under today's image, exercising her phonetics to flip acrobatic English easier for her. Foreign tongue was Spanish in Jamaica, Jamaican in Canada, Canadian in New York, reaching for citizenship, red tick out of range with immigration on her heels until her last breath evaporated above Los Angeles, as black as plans, her make-belief colored children sifted, accent-free, obscured behind Jamaica, Panama was blindfolded, monolingual. My English now rolls rickety, rickety, one cold shoulder ago. Latin America recognized me no more than Jamaica did. Call me American boy. Under breath, over unbroken speech patterns, I felt lost in translation while visibly in. Neither command of enough Spanish nor Patois to correct the secrets hiding her inside me, undetectable, even in death. She is around the border of my eye while I, tongues away from the language she learned to speak unnoticed, is in New York of my tongue, two generations away, and I'm in the dark of the dance hall. Multiple Spanish reggae tones mocking the star-spangled portion of my red, black, and green footwork, falling off every drumbeat chuckle, this collage of a woman, tilted between her locks and patois, flowing from Latin roots when she spoke me speechless when she smiled me the sunset that rolled across the coastline of her lips, crashed into her dimples, so beautiful, foreign, and familiar, she somehow made me homesick for a place I had never been. Thank you.